Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about how to print different characters in square shape by using simple concepts in basic Python, whichever we have talked about till now. So to start with that, let me get the number of rows from the user by using input function. So we have already seen how to get the input from the user. So for example, I want to get number of rows from the user, so enter the number of rows. So you already know whatever we get from by using input function from the user, the data type of that is nothing but in string. So what I will do is, as it's a row of, as it is number of rows, so I'm going to convert this into integer. See here, what we want to do is we want to print a square shape for different characters. So this is what is n1 is equal to int of input of enter the number of rows. Now we will use a for loop. We will try it with the help of for loop. So for I in range function, we already talked about, by default range function starts from 0, and other arguments which range function accepts is the start, the stop and the step. These are three arguments. So if I press shift tab, you can check the document string about range function or the train object, range object. So n1 is number of rows for I in range of n1. So we already know the syntax of for loop. I will use one more for loop for j in, again range function, for j in range of this n1. So number of rows and number of columns, we will have to take care about that. And what we can do is we can print the character by using a print function. So I want to print, suppose I want to print at the rate, and I want to print till we get the end, right? So and here what you can do is you can print the result. Okay. So if I try to run it, it should ask me number of rows first. So if number of rows, if I give as 10, let's check what it is showing as a result. So see, you can get these 10 rows in square shape. So this is how you can get a square shape. If you want space here, you can do that. If I will run it once again, and see, you can have a square shape of different characters. So you could have changed the characters also. If I want star, and once again run it, for example 12 number of rows, run it, sorry, okay, press enter, and now see, you will get star shape. So like this you can have any other character. If I want dollar, run it, and suppose 15 rows I give it, and enter. So see, this is what I am getting in square shape. So it's very simple by using input function, range function and for loop. So we have used two for loops in this case, right? Now the same thing can also be done with the help of concatenation and multiplication. So let me check if I do it like 8. So this is what we are getting in square shape. Now the same thing can be done by using concatenation and multiplication symbol. So how to do that? So let's get number of rows from the user the same way which we have done in the first case, and now we will use only one for loop here. So for I in range, so there are a number of ways you can do the same thing. So I in range of n1 is the number of rows which we are getting from the user, and the indentation will be taken care by Jupyter here, as there is in Jupyter. So I want to print, suppose I want again, I again want to print at the rate character, and I want to multiply number of rows with that n1 number. So what it is going to do is at the rate n1 times, I want n1 times, so n1 is suppose 8. So in the 0th row, it is going to print 8 at the rate sign, then one row 8 at the rate sign, then second row 8 at the rate sign. So the same thing, this same thing can be done, sorry, this same thing can be done with the help of these three lines. So let me check it. I will run it. Suppose 10 number of rows, see, it can be done the same way using these lines. So this is by using multiplication and concatenation. So this is how you can get the square shape. If you want to change the character here also, we can do that. I will run it once again. 10 number of rows if I give, so you will get this all stars in square shape. So again, if you want space, that can be done here, right? 10 number of rows, sorry, enter. Now you will get all the stars in square shape. So this is how you can print any shape. In the next videos, we are going to talk about different shapes by using Python, and which will be involving just the basic Python concepts. So that's it, friends. Thank you very much.